History repeats itself. Lots of movement is happening at the people from today's hottest startup. But there's more. When people hear the name OpenAI, they think of Sam Altman, Microsoft, and of course, ChatGPT. However, there are plenty of people related to the AI hype that spun over this company. What exactly can we expect to happen within the next acts of these powerful people? What do I mean by saying history repeats itself? Why is the word mafia in this video's title? And what has all of this to do with Elon Musk? Let's find out. Hi, my name is Ayhan. I'm a freelance software engineer in Germany and I share my experiences about tech, engineering and self-employment with you guys. But today's video is about a never told story about success, intrigues and power. First, let's go back in time a bit. To be precise, to the year 1995, our young entrepreneur Elon Musk co-founded a company called Zip2 and sold it a short time later to Compaq, you remember, for $300 million. Few years later, Peter Thiel co-founded an online payment company called Confinity in 1998. 1 year later, our now pretty wealthy entrepreneur Elon Musk invested some of his money from his exit from Zip2 to also found an online payment service company called X.com. Does that ring a bell? 1 year later, so 2000, the two investors merged their ventures and Confinity became X.com, only for it to be renamed short time later to one company that everybody knows today, PayPal. PayPal was a huge success and it didn't take too long for it to be bought off entirely by eBay for over $1.5 billion, which was shared across a group of founders of PayPal who were from then infamously called the PayPal Mafia. With Peter Thiel, CEO of PayPal, or Don of the Mafia, getting over $55 million from this, and Elon Musk reaching even $175 million. However, money wasn't enough for these 23 members of the PayPal Mafia. I think the career of Elon needs no introduction. But the exceptionality of the group was that Elon himself was not that much of a unicorn at that group. Let's quickly wrap it up. The members of the PayPal Mafia founded well-known companies like Yelp, LinkedIn, YouTube, Palantir, Stripe, SpaceX, Tesla, and had their influence in Airbnb, Facebook, Flickr, GitHub, Last.fm, the Mozilla Corporation, the cryptocurrency Ripple, Twitter, and held multiple seats in leaderboards, C-level positions, and more in big startups and companies like Sequoia Capital, Square, Google, and much more. And it seems like everything these people touch turns to gold. And they have their fingers in most of the products, technology, and services we are using every day in our life. Just like a Silicon Valley Mafia, right? Or right now. So we know about the PayPal Mafia now, but why is this word in the title of this video? Do you remember I said history repeats itself? PayPal members splitting out and taking over the world is not a unique thing for hyper successful startups. The story is as old as the Silicon Valley itself. In the early beginnings, when Silicon in its name was still corresponding to the Valley, the traitorous eight left Shockley Semiconductors to found their own competition with their valuable experience in their former work. Whenever a startup blows up like this, it's usually only a matter of time until the employees become self-employed founders themselves. And that's just how things go, nothing to hate here. But why now the emphasis on the PayPal Mafia? Well, before we get to OpenAI, let's quickly check what the PayPal Mafia members have done and influenced in the tech world and what role they play in the artificial intelligence industry and in particular for OpenAI. The three most well-known members of the PayPal Mafia were Peter Thiel, Reid Hoffman and, of course, Elon Musk. Since their exit from PayPal, they have invested and founded some of the most influential companies of the world right now. While they have had their own investments, it was not seldom that they have behaved like an elite club that have taken their partners into promising investments and put their old friends into advantages when there was a big opportunity on site. For instance, both Hoffman and Thiel were early investors into Facebook short time prior to the big betrayal of Eduardo Severin. Was that a coincidence? Whenever some of them founded a promising company, guess who was the first on board and involved in the early beginnings? Okay, but over time, an outsider seemed to hop in and shows up among them on the dinner table and intersected more and more with the interests of these elite players. The name? Samuel Altman. Involved in some of the most successful investments like Airbnb or Stripe, Thiel and Altman also shared their passion for supporting young founders, Sam being the president of Y Combinator and Thiel being the owner of Thiel Fellowship, which grants 100k to young students to drop out of school and pursue their business ideas. And now it's time to spill the tea. There's only one company that all four of these men invested and were involved in a significant manner. The startup everyone talks about, OpenAI. Everyone who thought the massive success of OpenAI was sheer luck or had anything to do with it should know better by now. OpenAI is a once-in-a-lifetime success story backed by the entrepreneurs who silently rule the tech world and led by the most talented scientists in the field of artificial intelligence in the history. Only when the company switched from a non-profit to a for-profit model, players like Microsoft entered the stage. Until then, a wild ride from Elon Musk being the head, leaving them for good, multiple CEOs and CTOs from companies such as Stripe, Google, Tesla joining the company, Altman becoming CEO, getting fired by the board, Microsoft threatening to take all their employees to create their own AI competition, to Altman being reinstalled as CEO after only 5 days, and ended with Microsoft investing over $13 billion and owning 94% of OpenAI's for-profit arm and being investigated upon from the EU antitrust regulations. But all of this is already out there. You can find any of these events and investigate in detail about it. But we care about the potential repetition of history, the birth of the OpenAI Mafia. And to say the least, it has already begun. Over the past 6 years, over 30 employees from OpenAI have left them and started their own businesses, many of them with great success. Let's take a look at the most enticing of their new ventures. Maddie Hall, former Special Projects Manager at OpenAI, founded Living Carbon, a public benefit to fight climate change by rebalancing the planet's natural carbon life cycle. The startup, being the least valuable of them, is funded with $36 million. Pretty sad if you ask me that no one cares about the environment so much as they do in other fields that are more profitable. But that's again how things go, I guess. Close up, Jeff Arnold, former head of operations, and Jonas Schneider, former tech lead at OpenAI, formed their companies Pilot and Daedalus with fundings of $172 million and $41 million respectively. Peter Chen, former research scientist, formed Covariant, creating the world's first AI robotic solutions to automate pick-and-place processes in warehouses and fulfillment centers. Covariant has been founded to date with over $222 million. Getting bigger now, right? David Lewin, former VP of Engineering, founded Adept, a $450 million funded company providing AI models to automate the usage of every software tool there is in the world. These startups alone have a valuation or funding of over $880 million. But there's one that makes all of them look like a child's toy. Dario and Daniela Amodei founded their startup Anthropic in 2021, a company that received fundings for over $7.6 billion in less than 3 years of existence. The twins left OpenAI as their dispute of their vision for building safety into AI models rised with OpenAI. Daniela was vice president of people and vice president of safety. Dario was the former vice president of research at OpenAI. By the way, the first person who thought about giving the AI models an unfinished programming software task and asking it to finish it. And ultimately, he's the reason why GitHub Copilot, an AI tool that helps with programming in astonishing speed and efficiency, came into existence way before we saw ChatGPT in the wild. With their new venture, alongside five co-founders, all of which were former staff at OpenAI, they work on AI safety research. That includes the first mature approach on constitutional AI, a radical method on aligning AI systems with each other and let them train each other to ensure harmlessness of artificial intelligence systems that we have today and in the future with artificial general intelligence. But also their own AI assistant Claude, which is widely considered a close competitor to GPT-4, OpenAI's strongest model, and even Google Gemini. Let's come to an end here. The value of these ventures formed by former OpenAI staff reaches 75% of OpenAI itself. And even if they won't succeed over their ex-parent or don't even plan to, one might predict that the future of tech lies in artificial intelligence and the research and progress in it. And the sum of these entrepreneurs alongside OpenAI, Google, Meta and Microsoft will form an oligopoly that is hard if not impossible to enter. Just like a mafia, isn't it?